Hey guys, here we go. Put a line through it. Episode 8, big boys, the Ballarat Cup. How you feeling, Tone?
Oh, mate, all confident. Big day coming up tomorrow. Ready to fill up the coffers. Set to go. Yes.
We need a fill up, Tone. We need a fill up.
We do. Yes, we need a fill up. We're out in the country this week, so we're a little bit like a bit disorientated, like a pickpocket in a nudist camp. So, you know, we've got to sort of feel our way there tomorrow. No, Jamie.
It's a sad day. It's a very sad day tomorrow. Our little splitty, no one of the boys don't want to go past. If I was on a horse, Tone, and I had Jamie Carr in front, like, you know, I don't want to be sexist. I don't want to be rude, but God, that's a nice view.
Oh, yes, you wouldn't, yeah. You definitely want to park yourself behind that, wouldn't you?
Jeez, we've started off with a bang this week.
It's not like some of the Tankensteins walking around.
All right, we better stop. Jesus
Christ. Grown men fighting in a sugar bag, you know?
Oh, mate, I just want to, bit of a shout out this week, Tone, to my mates up in Cairns, the pricks are doing it really hard. You know, they've never worn a mask. They've never really socially distanced at all. They were getting paid from the Morrison government for months. They all work in the casino. They've just gone back to work. They bought a horse, Annie. We call her Modernism. She's just gone bang, two in a row. She ran on November 10th in Townsville. Mate, it was like a Winx run. It was like a Hugh Bowman slaughter. Justin Stanley was, he was pretending he was cancerous, Craig. He was like, oh, I'm on the best horse. I know what I've got underneath. It was a shocking. It was six lengths last with fucking 500 to go, Tone. Like, you couldn't win unless you play caviar. You know, like, it was amazing.
Oh, dear, oh dear. They're doing it tough, aren't they? They're doing it tough down there, the boys.
Oh, they're doing it tough up there, mate. Oh, seriously. Oh, yeah. Fucking
which
hell.
Which brings to mind. You've got to give a shout to the Neon Cowboy.
Oh, the Nippon Cowboy.
Yeah.
And only true subscriber on YouTube. He comments every week. We don't give him any love. Bit of a shout out to the Nippon Cowboy.
Yes, mate.
I thought it was Big Swinger, but I don't think it's Big Swinger anymore. We've got a mate over here we call Big Swinger. We call him the Big Swinging Cock. When he comes into a room, he pretends he's got the biggest dick. We don't think it's him. So, Nippon Cowboy, a lot of love coming your way. Thanks, mate.
Thanks, mate. Yeah. Keep in there. Hang in there.
About Modernism, Tony. About Modernism, I'm going to put the video to watch Justin Stanley time this race to perfection. Actually gets eased down over the line. That's how well it wins. So, this horse, it could be the Black Caviar of the North. So, I'll put that in the comments in the description. You can watch the replay from November 10th. Sorry, Modernism boys, I should have shouted you out. But I was trying to protect the price, but Tony, up in Cairns, when they're any good, the price is usually going pretty quickly anyway.
Right, yeah. You don't get much up there, do you? They don't give much away.
Well, you know, something at 14 to 1, like in Melbourne, would be 200 to 1.
Right.
Yeah. Hey, mate, I've got my son come over. Isn't that beautiful timing?
Yeah, big fella, there he is.
He just called me fat too, the little prick.
Oh, a little Tankenstein.
Oh, I respect that. No, he's been calling me fat a lot, Tone, and he only does it in front of his mother. So I told him, you should fucking say it as soon as you come home tomorrow, and he did. So I respect, well done, Noah, you little prick. Anyway, okay, let's go, Tone. Let's get amongst it. Let's get into it. Are you ready?
Yes, mate. Fire away.
Okay, big boy, here we go. Put a line through it. We've got the rainbow colours because we're not homophobic at all. Love is love, 2020. Up, thoughts and prayers.
Oh, there she is. Shame she's not running around this weekend.
Thoughts and prayers, Jamie. We're going to miss you.
Yes.
We did miss one thing yesterday. What we did miss in our Facebook group, we usually put a couple of black bookers or a few of our keen subscribers that enjoy Facebook or the Book of Face. We had one up yesterday in Omen Bet, Yenhab. Does that ring a bell, Tone?
Oh, certainly does. Barney spelled backwards, isn't it?
That's Barney spelled backwards.
Now,
hey, Every Barney I've ever fucking met, including my own Barney, is fucking backwards.
Tone, oh dear.
I'll tell you a quick story, Tone. I jumped on this horse at 2 days ago at $50. 51 bucks I boosted it to from 34. 2 days ago, I got on at fucking $27. It wins at $3.40. What the fuck is going on there, Tony?
Jesus, they're all backing it with the ears pinned back, though.
Mate, it opened at $101.
Ooh, they're all over that like white on rice.
Golly. White on rice. That's how much of a scumbag Barney is. Even the horse is a scumbag. You know, it opens up at 101 and wins at $2.70. Like, what the fuck is going on with fucking Yen Hub and Barney?
Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
Oh,
yeah,
mate. Pig of a horse. Absolute pig. But, geez, it was a good run. It was a massive run. You know, it was really slowly ran. Scooped them up in a fucking bound, mate. 1 by 3.
A lot of educated money on it, obviously.
A lot of money was on that, of course. Big boy, we have a look at our rehabs. Here we go. We're still in profit. Just last week, the Tone's titanium tip just goes bang.
That was it. Sound. Came home like a young bloke on a promise. Said it would. Shouldn't have got beat to start before. Last week, got the job done. Yeah, beautiful ride. Not a bad price.
Great price. Way to go, Paula. Peasant's Push. Absolutely butchered. Ridden upside down. Was taken out 3 lengths last. Comes around the bend, went for more runs than Steve Smith. Absolutely battled on like, geez, it was like an F1 in the end. It was screaming home, but the race was all over. Way to go, Paula. Absolutely bulleted. So I'll probably, I'll back up to this one, Tone. I'll get back into Paula. Now, Tone, a bit of a sad story last week. Talking about Sound, you backed up into Sound. There was one other horse that ran last week that won and we didn't back up. We put a line through.
Shimino.
Oh, Jamie. Jamie.
How did I feel? I felt like I'd been smacked around more times than a red-headed stepsister.
Oh, the red-headed stepsister one. There we go. That's an old
one. I had a massive bet on Shimino. Big, fat zero. Didn't have a cracker on it.
We put a line through it last week in the show, Tom.
We certainly did, yep.
That's how smart we are.
Oh, yeah, we're poisonous.
We could have had the car double. The car double.
We should have gone the S into the S, eh? Shimino into Sound.
Well, thanks that might be coming. There might be a little bit of a spoiler alert there, big boy, in the titanium tip and the out of the rough. It might be a the double.
Oh, the double.
Here we go, big boy. The quaddy, no good. We're absolutely fucking embarrassed about the quaddy. Last week, it would have cost somebody like nearly close to 55 bucks to put the quaddy on for 10%. We missed two, we got the first 2 legs, missed the last two. Absolutely fucking disgraceful. We're costing ourselves money. So this week, the quaddy, Tone, we've gone 4 by 4 by 4 by 4 in the most open, probably betting race day in the fucking world in Ballarat. We are mental.
Yeah, well, that's right. I mean, you know, we try to keep it within a, you know, within a feasible sort of sum, don't we? Like 4 by 4 by 4 by 4 is better.
Well,
and Jesus, it's tough this weekend.
If you're a $100 punter, you're fine because you would have got 500 back from Sound. You've lost 100 on Way to Go, Paula, and the quaddies only cost you 50, 55 bucks because there was a couple of scratchings. So you're still in profit. But if you're a 10-buck punter, Tone, you've done your ass on the quaddy.
Yeah.
You know, it's cost you 55 to put on. You got 50 back. You've ended up losing about $7. So this week, what we're going to do, Tone, from now on, the quaddy is 2 from you, 2 from me, and thoughts and prayers go out to the quaddy gods. And we just hope we get a lot of shitload of money back for not a lot of outlay.
Yeah, well, it's the only way to go, isn't it? Like, right. We pick our very best two for each leg.
Yep.
And, you know, especially like this week, you know, they're big fields, massive
mate,
fields.
Mate, if you get the quaddy in Ballarat, I swear to God, if you've outlaid 25, 26 bucks for 10%, if we hit this week, big boy, we might be going viral. And I don't mean corona pandemic viral. I mean fucking viral.
Viral. Yes.
If we can tip these Muppets into the quaddy in Ballarat tomorrow for $25, fucking hell. We should get a little bit of love there in the comments, I tell you. Yeah. Anyway, mate, okay, let's get back into it. We always get a bit confused and random, don't we, big boy? Okay, Michael Boy, get fucked. Yeah? Way to go, Paula. Sorry, come back up again, Tony. Fuck off, Michael Poy, you fucking little apprentice prick who now is a fucking qualified jockey. After last week's ride on Way to Go, Paula, I think he should go back to school, Tony.
Shocking. That was terrible. You know, I mean, honestly, he couldn't find a grand piano in a one-room house. That was disgusting. Shocking. Absolutely putrid. Horrendous.
Well, Melbourne races tomorrow, Tone. As you explained, it's a bit weird. We're in Ballarat.
Yeah, in the sticks tomorrow.
You know what the best thing about Ballarat is, mate?
Beer.
The Ballarat Road.
Oh.
Where you can fucking get out of it. Mate, okay, here we go. The quaddy in Ballarat, here we go. Big boy, race number 7. We've got numbers 2, 3, 6, and 16. Tony, a bit of controversy here. Pears has gone kaplumpish.
My God, you wouldn't want to say that 10 times when you're pissed, would you?
Well, have a look who's riding the bastard.
Oh, no.
Yo!
Cancerous.
I've gone. Cancerous bag. I've gone. The biggest self-promoter outside of the big swinger here over here in Fukuoka. The only reason is I love Kevin Corson's. Corson's stable is absolutely on fire, big boy. I think they've got 9 out of 13. Their last 13 runners, they've had 9 winners, big boy.
Wow.
So
yeah, on fire.
I'm going to give Kaplumpich another chance, even with Cancerous Craig on board. You're pretty keen on the 3 and the 6, if I remember correctly.
Yes, right you are. I know it's favourite. I don't like tipping favourites, but I think this is a pretty good horse. Zara's on it. Good run last start.
Yeah.
So I think it's in the real show coming out of Barrier 4.
Yeah, we've got a bit of value. A bit of value on the 16. Betty Mellon, Danny O'Brien. A bit of a country thing coming in at $26. We can't leave it out. It's honest as the day is long. And you like the Think and Fly of Oliver for Hayes.
I do, yeah. I think a couple of good wins it's got behind its belt. I think $12. I think it's a little bit overpriced, yeah. But no, yeah. It's a tough race. Coming out of Barrier 7. $12, yeah, I think it's good value.
Yeah, if we get one outside of the 5, we're away. Value aplenty, we're going to make some money. Race number 8, we've got 4, 6, 10, and 20. All the even numbers here, big boy.
There we go. How's that? Mm. So you're on the, you've gone the 4 and the 6?
Yeah, I think Junipel's probably the best horse in it, the most progressive. You know, yeah, it's on fire at the moment. It's absolutely letting them down. It's a step up in class. You know, we've put a line through Sosie Bond again because the prick cost us last week.
That's well bred, you know. Oh. It's very well bred. It's by Cook the Books out of Enron Accountant. And last time it was ridden by A Fraud. Scumbag. That would have to win. That four-legged oxygen band, it would have to win at 1,000 to 1 for me to get my money back.
Oh.
It's an absolute scumbag.
Oh, shit. Okay. Yeah. We've put a line through Kingsville Dream. We just think it's over. Harlem, fucking Craig Williams on board can get fucked. How many horses I've backed in this race and lost money on, it's undescribable. I think I've lost money on every horse. I'm pretty keen on the 6 for Johnny Allen, Archie Alexander. I like Archie. I think it's been trying to get up to a reasonable distance. Hopefully there's a couple of scratchings and it comes in a couple. But that'll be our value anyway. You're pretty keen on the 10. Zara again for Danny O'Sullivan. Yep. Good horse.
He's got a fair show. $5.50 is not a bad price. It's another tough race.
Mm.
And Parody.
Yeah.
I know I'm giving Damo a big day. I'm expecting him to have a really big day.
Yeah, I expect Oliver to kick back a bit. He's been riding like fucking you or me. Like, as in fucking shit house.
Yeah, he's been off the boil. But tomorrow could be the day. A little out in the country. Parody, don't mind Parody. It's coming out of the car park, but $9.50 is not a bad price. And wasn't a bad second. I think they're on a second last start. Yeah, it wasn't a bad second.
Yeah, fuck Sosie Bond.
Yeah. Oh, dog. Absolute dog.
Okay, we're getting into race 9, big boys. This is the smallest field. You know, there's only about 11 in it. So we've got numbers 2, 3, 5, and 9. Again, I've gone Cancerous Craig, the astrologist, probably one of the biggest bets tomorrow, I think, what I've seen. Everybody's tipped it. Bennett Racing. I'm a big fan of Bennett Racing, big boy. We've got a couple of horses with the great man, Nathan Bennett, from Geelong, a Geelong boy. So as you all probably know, I'm from Geelong. You know what the best thing about Geelong is, Tony?
No, mate.
The Ballarat Road, you can get out of Geelong. Sorry, bad joke. The astrologist, really honest horse, bit stiff, bit of a bad ride from Craig last start, bit of a butcher, come second. I think you can get the job done here, but big boy, we're both black booked at one here, aren't we? Number 5.
We have, yes, yes. I've gone on Damo again, can't be done on the 2.
Yeah.
Around 10 skins. But, yeah, with the five, we were locked in this as the roughie of the century.
Oh!
Roughie is the century here.
That's the Black Panther, the prick died, didn't he? He died, the poor bugger, the Black Panther, the one who played in the movies. They put this away. They're freshened it up. It's had a spell for, I think, nearly close to 2 months. It's freshened up. Country horse. Started favourite both its fucking starts. I think I was on both times. Comes to the city after a bit of a freshen up at 50s. Let's go.
Get on. All aboard the gravy train. Yeah, could be our little power boost there in the quaddy if we're 2 legs in.
Oh, mate, if the old Black Panther turns up, we'll be right above here.
If he pounces.
Oh, we're pouncing like the Black Panther indeed. And then in the last, big boy, we've got numbers 4, 11, 17, and 19. Pez really likes the 11. It's in the market again for Benny Allen and Shay Eden. Man, she can train, mate. So she doesn't usually bring him to the city, but it's not the city. It's Ballarat, big boy, but it's still a Saturday meet. And I love B Hunter against your fucking power scheme 2 weeks ago. Power scheme nearly pinched a race last week. Power Scheme's in the Kilmore Cup on Sunday. It's been scratched this for tomorrow.
Ah, there we go.
Johnny Sadler, last race of the day. He's the best. So I reckon B Hunter is cherry ripe for Barrier 2. Jordan Childs is a prick. Don't mention Jordan Childs to me about Surprise Baby 2 years ago at the Melbourne Cup. Cost me fucking thousands.
Oh.
Fuck you, yeah, Jordan Childs. But if he rides B Hunter home in the last leg of the quaddy after the Black Panthers got up, happy days, big boy.
True. Yep, I've gone for Star Missile Zara to, in the big show here, coming out of Barry.
I think you've tipped Zara in nearly every leg.
Oh, yeah, done me homework. Well, I hope I have.
Right.
I think 8.50, coming out of Barry 10. It's a tough little race.
Yep.
And also very keen on the difference. Number 19.
You are the fucking difference, big boy.
The difference, yeah.
You are the fucking difference.
Luke Curry can ride a horse too, don't worry.
The difference of what? I'm not sure, mate, but you are the fucking difference. You can read that either way, mate, as a positive or a negative, but you are the fucking difference. Probably one we could have put in was Johnny Allen for Leon and Troy Corson's at Titan Blinders, you know. But we've said before, we said, big boy, we're only going 4 by 4 by 4 by 4, 2 each. We're not going anymore.
Yep, we're not putting a whole lot in. Like you said, try to keep it down so, your investment's a lot lower. And of course, there's value in what we tip that we think is pretty well big chance of winning.
Okay. All right, big boy. So before we get going, we've got our titanium tip coming and the Pez's push. Big day racing tomorrow. Some exciting news, though, Tone. Monday, what are we going to try and do Monday?
Oh, Monday. Yes, we're going to try and do a review, aren't we? We're going to try and do a review.
Yep.
And so it's fresh in everybody's minds, fresh in our minds, and it's sort of we'll cut down this show of a Friday.
Yeah, so that's the idea, guys. We're going to try to do a bit of a quick review, a bit of a laugh about the weekend. Hopefully we can record our results. So then next week we can just get straight into the quaddy and straight into the tips, and we try not to annoy you Muppets for as long as we do.
Exactly. Yeah, Barney needs the time to be able to get his bets on.
Oh, mate, I don't mean I mean Muppets in a really negative way too, Tone. I'm not positive at all. They're a fucking bunch of, if they're fucking listening to us, how bad are their lives going?
Oh, there you go. There you go, hey, eh?
One thing. What did Barney send us this week in message? He sent us a little photo, big boy. Did you see that?
Oh, right. Barney.
Yeah.
Barney. Yeah, he got himself some nice kickers, hasn't he?
Oh, hey? Barney, he's the rain man of the channel. He's made so much money. He's gone out and bought himself a pair of Michael Jordan
ones. You can see him prancing around. He's like a fucking rat. It flashes a rat with a gold tooth. That's Barney.
Jason, and you know the funny thing is he fucking lives in Cairns, the prick. So how the fuck is he going to wear a pair of Jordans around Cairns? He'll get fucking raped. Oh, that's probably what he's are. He's probably, that's probably what he's aiming for. But mate, someone will knock him over the head and take his fucking pair of Jordans.
Good investment, Barney. Good investment.
Oh, mate, what a prick. Anyway, let's give Barney more. Barney needs a new pair of shoes, big boy. I never thought I'd be saying that. Tone, I never thought I'd be saying that on fucking on a YouTube thing. Barney needs a new pair of shoes, so let's get him one. Big boy, here we go. The titanium tip.
Here she comes. Roll out the red carpet. Oh, there we go. There we go. Got to, everyone, sorry, got to wait until race 10, number 4. Is that right? Number 19.
Oh, race. Fuck yeah.
Oh, dear, your mathematics is getting...
Oh, what am I doing, Tony?
What happened there? You're all over the place like an unquestioned dog. That's a 1 and a 9. That's
it. How can I not? Jesus Christ.
There we go.
Tony, race 10, number 19. The difference.
That's the one, the difference. Luke Curry doing the steering, trained by McAvoy. Good third last start, 9:50. Get on now.
It should come in. Could come in a couple of barriers because I reckon there might be a couple of scratching. So she'll probably jump from around 10 or 11. Adelaide Horse, of course, famous owners. I forget who the fucking rich cunts who own it, or we shouldn't say that word. The rich people who own it, but a really, really honest horse, Tone. So I reckon you might be on the ball here, big boy.
Yes, and I reckon the price might be a little bit skinny come the jump tomorrow. It could be as skinny as the girl next door. She's that skinny, she has to run around underneath the shower to catch the drops. Wow. And if she's standing sideways, you won't see her. So the price is going to come in, so get on at 9:50.
Well, we don't have to worry about that, do we, big boy?
No, mate, no.
The water does definitely hit us.
Certainly does, yeah.
And Tone's out of the rough. Tone's out of the rough. Here we go. We're on the Black Panther, big boy.
We are, yes. We both came to the agreement here, didn't we?
Yeah, we both black booked it. We've both been waiting for it. We didn't think it was probably going to start on a Saturday meet, but again, it's Ballarat, so it's sort of in the country for the Panther.
They've snuck him out there to the Big B.
Big boy, I do like it, though. The into the... Let's go.
Well, of course. There we go. There's an omen right there.
Mate, if that comes up in anything, that's like a 500-to-1 little double there, big boy. That's in absolutely.
Oh, Barney, you'll be bombing.
Jace might actually buy a real pair of fucking 1984 Jordans if that this comes up. Okay, big boy, the $4.95 fill up. Now, a bit of controversy, big boy. I couldn't find a fucking peasant's push for tomorrow, so I've actually gone to Sunday. Boom! Tavi dance, let's go. Mate, we're into the Kilmore Cup on Sunday. And again, Damien Oliver, we're back in Damien Oliver in a bit, aren't we?
Oh, we are.
Mickey Price, Mick Kent Jr., amazing strike rate. This horse basically ran around 2 weeks ago, I think, in Flemington. And, mate, it got more cock blocked than Barney at a second Sydney Mardi Gras. Fair dinkum. He you know, what do you say, Tone, when you fall into a barrel full of nipples or something? What do you say, something about that?
Oh, yeah, come out sucking your thumb.
Well, that's how Tabba Dance ran 2 weeks ago. It fell into a barrel full of tits and come up sucking a thumb. It was absolutely fucking, oh, my God. I felt violated. I had no money on it. And I'm like, whenever this is going to start again, I'm on like fucking white on rice. Tabby Dance, $5. Jump on now. It's going to start shorter. Bang, bang, bang. Now, I don't have a tip for a Saturday, so it's a bit controversial, Tony. Big controversial, big boy. Maybe all the little Muppets out there going, oh, we can't tip on a Saturday. Well, I've got one for you. Sunny Coast, last race, number 17, Green Jacket.
Oh, my God. Look at that.
Tony, this horse absolutely flew home when the race was all over last week. And at this price at 20-1, Jimmy Byrne in the saddle, the Damien Oliver of the North. Mate, yes. I couldn't believe it opened up at this price. This is absolutely incredible. It blew my mind.
Yeah, that's way over the odds, isn't it? 19-1.
Yeah, I thought it was going to be about 10s, you know, but when it opens up at 20s, I just jumped straight on. I think the Edmonds boys, they go really well. They're pretty dodgy bastards, so I like them. Green Jacket, when you look at the silks, there's nothing green about it, so I like that even more. Jimmy Byrne, jump on board, throw a couple of bucks. You won't, you know, your $4.95 fill up might get you back your 100, so let's go. But anyway, Sunday, Kilmore Cup, Tabby Dance. We might have to sleep on the difference into Tabby Dance on the Sunday. Very exciting Saturday night for our loyal subscribers.
Yeah, well, there's value aplenty there. And, you know, if the betting gods, you know, shine down some love on us, it could be a very, very good weekend.
Tone, I think that's about all we've got time for. You know, I know everybody's just wants us to keep talking because it's so entertaining. But that might be it.
That's about all we've got for today, haven't we? Oh, yeah. I've got one for you.
Oh, shit.
What are two words a Scotsman and a New Zealander will never say in a pub?
I don't know.
My shout.
Oh, shit. I was going to say my shout because I just thought that's just too obvious or too ridiculous. Thanks for that, Tone. So basically, we're being sexist, we're being homophobic, now we're being discriminatory against people from New Zealand and Scotland. I think we've done all right.
We've done well. Yeah, everybody.
Yeah. But the thing is, Tone, if the different comes up and Tabby Dance and the Kilmore Cup hits on Sunday, nobody gives a fuck what we say.
As long as they can keep taking those readies out of the ATM, who cares?
Oh, as long as Jace can keep buying his Jordans number ones, the Chicago Cut. What a fucking... I was going to say poofter, but we can't say that. It's 2020. It's no good. But what a cock. Fair dinkum. Imagine him walking around up in Cairns with a pair of Jordans on. Fucking hell. He's going to get fucking hammered. Like, you know, you could probably get away with it in the bigger cities. Not sure about Cairns, but good luck, Jace.
Here we go. Yep.
All right. Nippon Cowboy, thanks very much for your support. We love you. Don't know who the fuck you are. You're a good bloke. Well done. If you're actually in Japan, as in Nippon, Japan, let us know. Hit us up and maybe we can go have a beer. Once this third wave gets over, and we won't mention the third wave. But okay, boys, the difference, remember the Black Panther, Green Jacket for me on tomorrow for a roughie, but of course, Tabby Dance and the Kilmore Cup. Let's go, big boy. Just before, I think I forgot one thing, big boy. The difference into Tabby Dance, that'll get you around 47.50, big boy, 50-1. Put your 10 skins on, get you back 500. There's your pair of Jordans. Bang.
Money in the bank. That's it.
Money in the bank. All right, big boy. Time to go. See you later.
Yep, see you later. All the best.
Thoughts and prayers.
Time. Oh, let's go. Balls deep at 11.
Yes. Balls deep at 11.
Peace.